Stand up, speak up, make yourself count. In a hypersensitive, ultra-reactionary world, how realistic is it to expect our cinema stars to stand up and speak up and make themselves heard? And what are the costs and consequences of doing so? In the midst of this raging debate over the film Padmaavati, over Hindutva, over sexy Durga, and at a time when most actors and artists seem to be losing their voice, we are joined at the India Today Conclave by some formidable personalities who've done exactly this, stood up and spoken out. Ladies and gentlemen, at the India Today Conclave South, join me in welcoming to our session actor Vishal, Prakash Raj, film director S.K. Sasidharan, and Dalit rights activist Dr. Kancha Ilaiah. Can we have a warm round of applause, please? Just today, the Supreme Court weighed in favor of free speech by saying that all the notifications put out by states against the film Padmaavati are void and people must have the right to watch the film if they please. So far, Prakash Raj, the artists, the crew, the filmmakers of Padmaavat had been left to the mercy of the goons. Do you believe this is dereliction of duty of the government not to stand up? You had to go to the courts. It's almost as if, despite what the censor board said, state governments are being their own super censor.
Good afternoon, everyone. See, when there is a writing on the wall, there is no conspiracy theory. That's called spade a spade. Now, these state governments are citing reasons of law and order. They should step down because they're not fit to be there in the first place. Or accept that with power, we are arm twisting. Then they should be sent out by us. There's only one way out. So this is very clear that they want to stop. They want to cater to a fringe group because of an oath. And it is a very straight, blatant attack on expression, on free expression. Let's not mince words at all.
But there is a popular sentiment as well, which is cited by these state governments in defense of their actions, saying that Rajput pride is hurt by the filmmaker, and when he's making a film, he should be mindful of how society perceives that.
I understand if it is happening only with Rajputs in Rajasthan. What has Gujarat got to do with it? What has Haryana got to do with it? Why are they claiming? Why are they foreseeing it? Isn't it? Yes, fine, yes. Yes, a filmmaker should be conscious of disturbing somebody's sentiment or questioning somebody's sentiment. But the filmmaker has claimed he has not done any of that. There is a central board of certification and they went to the Supreme Court and Supreme Court said, hello, excuse me, there is a board. I can't stand on their fingers, on their foot. Let them take a call. They wanted to cut somebody's head, nose. They ended up cutting an eye. Right? Fine. Now the censor says, okay, now what is your problem? Watch the film in the theaters, guys.
And I think, Vishal, that must be the overriding sentiment. If you're offended, stay at home. If you want to watch the film, come watch it. Object if you please by boycotting, not by physical intimidation. How unnerving is it for actors when someone is threatening to cut off your nose, punch your face? And in the instance of Padmaavati, you had goons of the Karni Sena actually storm into Bhansali's shooting.
Good afternoon, everybody. Well, I'm glad that this particular incident happened because a lot of things are coming into the forefront in our society at large. We all look up to justice, and yes, justice has prevailed at the end of the day. And I would be the next most happiest person after Mr. Sanjay Leela Bhansali that the film is going to see a good release. As Prakash Raj said, we always look up, when we study in school, we look up to our principal. When we study in college, it's the same. And then when we go into our profession, we look up to the autonomous bodies who actually make the decisions, and the decision is final. So when we filmmakers, we actors, when we move into, I wouldn't say a dangerous path, but trying to show fact and fiction together, once we get the certificate, we are good to go. I mean, if when I act on screen, I tell my filmmaker, my director, don't bother about my footwear below my knee. Because when I speak to the villain, when he's smoking, I'm dead sure that there is a scrolling. Because there's no point in me wearing good footwear, because it's not going to be seen. My only fear is, over the course of time, I'm scared that my face also will be, will not be seen, will not be visible. Because we have scrollings. We have scrollings for everything. We have, with due respect to the Animal Welfare Board, if you're using any animal in computer graphics, you have to mention that also. Then we have the fringe groups. Then we have political parties. Then if at all my family members also want to be part of the film, then I have their names also. So finally, where does filmmaking go to? I mean, the screen is never clean. So let us clean up the screen. Let us look up again to the Central Board of Film Certification. When it's called Central Board of Film Certification, that means it is certification alone, no censoring. It's not censored, it's certification.
You know, somebody who had a certification and yet was censored is S.K. Sasidharan. In the case of your film, Sexy Durga, you had a certification and yet you were completely censored. But I must, for a moment, play devil's advocate and ask you, why only Sexy Durga? Why not Sexy Fatima, Sexy Mary? Why only Sexy Durga?
See, this is not a question to be answered.
Why not?
This is a question to be neglected, because I'm a filmmaker. I made a film called Sexy Durga. So if you're asking why this name Sexy Durga, then I am supposed to answer that. But I have not made any film Sexy Fatima or Sexy Mary or anything. And there is no film such like that which is connected to me.
But that's the question that I ask. Why is there no film which says Sexy Fatima or Sexy Mary? Why are all films only about Sexy Durga?
See, the question is actually divisionism. This is not a question out of curiosity. This question comes, why you are making a film on some subject? Why you are not making a film on somebody else? And it is clearly a divisionism and making people sectarian. You know, you want to clash. You want to people clash and make get benefit from that.
But it isn't a binary, Prakash.
I'm not clashing with you. I'm saying that, you know, this kind of question is not constructive. If you're asking a constructive question, why you are making a film called Sexy Durga, I'm supposed to answer that. But I have not made any film named Sexy Fatima or anything.
No, but and it's not subject, just about you, Shashi.
See.
The fact is, Mr. Prakash Raj, that nobody has made a film about Sexy Fatima or Sexy Mary. Now, this is not just from a majoritarian impulse, but at some level a legitimate question. If there were some films about a Sexy Fatima, a Sexy Mary, and
I'll
then there was
you.
A Sexy Durga, there's no problem. But each time there is a film of this nature, it's only about a Sexy Durga. Why is that?
You use the word legitimate. It is not legitimate at all. He has made a film and its title is Sexy Durga. Simple. Why are you not making a film on Fatima? Because there's no subject on Fatima. Period. He is not here to... There's no film on that. The problem with these guys is they will never answer your question. The problem with these people who these questions is not the question for what I have asked. They have no problem with Durga wines. Do you know that? They have no problem with it at all. Durga mutton shop, Shiva mutton shop. They have no problem with that. I don't think that his film... title, Sexy Durga, means something. It's because of the subject. A subject, a thought process, what as a filmmaker I want to express, decides my title. It's not your whims and fancies to do a film on Sexy Fatima. No, I'll make Saint Fatima. Do they have a problem with that? They'll have a problem with that because I called Fatima a saint. These people have a problem. They want to divide. They want to. I ask questions. And they say, why are you not asking him? Aray, please answer my question, you, first. No, you should ask him also. I'll ask him first, you answer my question. They don't have answers.
The problem is, the questions are coming not for understanding. It is coming for making misunderstandings. That is the problem. If you are asking me why is sexy Durga, then I can answer why it is connected to the film, why the subject is demanding that name. But if you are asking me a question, why not sexy Fatima? Because I can't answer that because I have not made a film.
Vishal, the fact is that this would be an irrelevant question if not Sashi, but somebody had made a film, not just about Fatima or Mary, but you get the point that I'm trying to make. About other religions, there is hypersensitivity. Because there is a sense that Hindus are generally considered more liberal, therefore, I must ask this question. Therefore, you can say what you please and take liberties with Hinduism and with Hindu sensibilities, but nobody would dare mess with Muslim sensibilities or Christian sensibilities. It's a question that's asked now again and again. Let Vishal respond.
No, see, the question is arising only because, again, as you posed it to him, I don't think my filmmaker, my friend over here who I just met, is going to make a fast buck out of cheap publicity or just naming a film Sexy Durga, so probably people will throng to the theaters. I don't see what is the problem. As he said, you have names everywhere in for each and every for a store or for anything for that matter. What is wrong in him depicting a film? Why not we watch the film rather than watch the title? Why not we watch the film and decide on why he would have chosen Sexy Durga? If he had some kind of a wrong depiction, then we go into that. Then we go into, completely bifurcating every scene, everything.
Okay, so Shashi, why didn't you tell everyone?
The simple thing is, if the film is made against Hinduism, they have a question to ask. The filmmaker says there is nothing connected to religion at all. These people, they are saying it is anti-Hindu. It is not a Hindu film at all. Let me share this moment. 4 days back, I was in Sirsi on a stage talking against one central minister who says he wants to change the constitution. And I had a stage where it says, my constitution, my pride. And I, from that stage, asked him, dear minister, do you know there is a preamble to a constitution? Do you know what a preamble means? Now, 3 days later, day before yesterday, a group of this BJP people, youngsters, and the party have gone and put Gomutra on the stage where I have spoken and cleaned it. So I have asked them, wonderful, will this cleaning service happen wherever I go?
No, they also,
they exactly said, he is a beef eater. He supported eaters of beef. That's why we cleared. See, I did not speak about that on that stage. Did I? Just because I'm against Hinduism, they can create anything. This film is not about Hinduism. This film is not against Hindu tattvas, whatever it is. They say, no, it is because of that. That's why you have named title Sexy Durga.
So Prakash Raj, that same central minister you talk about, Anand Kumar Hegde, says that you do this deliberately because you get land from state governments. You're anti-Hindutva, and therefore, because you're getting acres and acres of land, you do this deliberately. How much land have you got?
Mind-blowing, because first of all, they have a claim that I have taken one small site, HSR layout, from Congress government in Karnataka. They don't know how many acres of land I have. That I've acted in 300 films across 5 states for the last 3 decades. How much of money I must have earned? I have adopted a village where I have given 6 acres to build a school. I recently donated 2 acres of my land to build a community hall. And they think I need a site in Bangalore. Look at them. Look how desperate they are. How uninformed they are. Such a beautiful thing, right? And they say, I am anti-Hindu. No, I am anti-Modi. I am anti-Hegde. I am anti-Amit Shah. And according to me, they are not Hindus. Mr. Anant Kumar Hegde, who says he wants to wipe out a ism, a religion from the face of this earth, cannot be a Hindu, ladies and gentlemen.
Rahul, I take strong objection to what he's saying about Modiji and Amit Shah. He says that they are not Hindus.
No, just because I'm anti, I'll tell you, the person who talks, who supports killing, cannot be a Hindu. No, are they the one who decides who's anti-Hindu? When they can decide I'm anti-Hindu, I will tell them you're not Hindu. Yes.
You know, one second. What we can do...
Please, I'm answering your question.
What
I'm
we can do is give you an opportunity to come in a little later. No,
yeah,
but
please.
We haven't asked you to
let,
ask
Let me
question.
Answer your first question. Yeah. People who say kill, according to me, are not Hindus. Sir... People who say, who support killers are not Hindus for me.
Okay,
yes.
Just one second. Okay, Prakash Raj, what I'll do is, I'll give him an opportunity to take a mic. One second, I'm having a mic sent to you. I'm having a mic sent to you, but after that interaction, you must sit and you must continue. I'll have a mic sent to you since you are offended and your party has been spoken against. Just, he's a spokesperson of the BJP here.
Yeah, I'm Krishna Sagar Rao, the spokesperson of BJP. Now, Prakash Raj, you're a good actor. There's no question about it.
Thank you.
See, BJP per se doesn't come down heavily on who to speak, what to speak, where to speak, how to speak. But the question is, when you're saying they and us, you're dividing already. And then the fringe you're talking about are the masses who might not be as educated as you are, as elite as you are, as smooth as you are, but they also have a right to protest. Democracy is about protest. It's about dissent. So when you speak, it's freedom of speech. When they speak, it is fringe. And when Durga...
They are talking...
No. 1 minute. 1 minute, brother.
Please complete your question.
Let me question.
You please complete it.
Yes.
And
yes.
Please have the patience when I answer.
Of course. I'll hear you. I've been hearing you uninterrupted till you said Modi ji and Amit Shah are not Hindus. Then only I rose. Okay? Now, Mr. Maker of Durga, we didn't have a problem. BJP didn't say anything about it. But what are your posters saying? He says that it has nothing to do with Hinduism. Why is Goddess Durga on the posters then? So what is the plan?
Okay.
Where?
So
maybe
you had an opportunity to ask
team
a question,
is doing
Mr. Rao. Now, if you can take
so
the
my
mic
question,
away.
My question simply is, when it is stand up and speak up for left-leaning
excuse
and
me.
The ultra-left.
Excuse me, one question.
Where
no.
is... Come on, man. Let me complete the question. When speak up, rise up, stand up, speak up on this panel is left, ultra left, center left, and the left itself. Now, why is that there is no right to speak up, stand up, and rise up?
And that's why we've given you the
why
opportunity
is that we don't
to
have
stand
a,
up
why,
and
why
speak
is that
up
we don't have a space here?
Okay.
We are ruling 73% of this country.
Okay, which is why we
it's
gave
unbelievable.
You the opportunity
See, the country
to stand
has been unfair.
It's a too long a question.
Okay, now in
can
the
I
thank
answer?
You. Prakash Raj, you can answer.
I'll answer.
You
there are around 10
to
questions.
Ask question.
There are around 10 questions in yours, so let me answer all of them. You can call me anti-Hindu, that I am not a Hindu, whoever it is. So I have the right to call them. Wait.
Now we can't continue like
now
this.
You
I've
can't
given
continue.
You an opportunity. This is not a TV debate. I'm sorry. You will have to listen. No, 1 second. Okay. This is where I call it. This is where I'm drawing a line, Mr. Rao. No. One more comment from you. I'm going to request you to leave because this is not the way we intend this interaction to happen. You are offended. I gave you an opportunity to ask a question. In the interest of fair play, I gave you the opportunity to ask a question. This is not somewhere you can come in and interrupt. You had an opportunity to ask a question. Now allow them to listen. Please don't say anything else. Yes.
We are basically talking about right to answer. We are talking about, you said no right is allowed. Anyway, you are talking about fringe groups. They are uneducated group and they do it. See, there are around 6 to 7 of your state governments where the Supreme Court says Padmavati should be played. And the fringe elements say it should not be played. And you, the ruling party, support them by saying we will ban the film. Instead of saying it, by the very fact that you are supporting, aren't you against us? Aren't you against the freedom of speech? Aren't you? Mr. Modi ji, when Modi ji says that when Gauri Lankesh, my friend, was killed, this whole thing started with a simple question that I saw celebrations about the killing. I never said who killed. I never pointed fingers at who killed. I said people are celebrating and this is violence, this is not right for the society. And the people who are celebrating are following, and the Prime Minister of my country is following these people. Why is he silent? Why is he saying, don't celebrate it, so that he gives me a secular feeling in this country? His silence, he may think it is silence, but it speaks, sir.
Kancha Ilaiah also speaks. Wants to come in. Because
it speaks, sir.
Is the left...
That's what I'm worried about. I say is, a true Hindu will not support such activities. A true Hindu, my Prime Minister should ask his minister, an elected, mandated minister, not to say a religion should be wiped out from this earth. That is not Hinduism, sir. And if my Prime Minister does not ask his minister to shut up, then I'm asking my Prime Minister, you're also not a Hindu. I have a genuine, straight question, sir. I am not looking at my Prime Minister as comes from a party. He is, whether I have voted for him or if I have not voted for him, he is still my Prime Minister. I have the right to ask him a question.
I've been sitting silent. The day when the ruling party and its representatives don't want to listen and interrupt the speakers of dissent, that day the Indian Constitution is in danger. Now, this is what's happening. The question today is, when it came to the films, it was about women. Whether Padmavati or Padmaavat or Goddess Durga or something else. What is happening in relation to Dalits, tribals, the backward classes? I come from a backward class. And my friends who disagree with me call me ultra-left. And I have never understood the definition of ultra-left. For them, Indian Constitution itself is ultra-left. Because it has a word called secularism in it. It has a word called socialism in it. Now, why are the Dalits, after this regime came into power, youngest Dalits are in protest, asking for the right to speak up? Yeah, there have been regimes of different political parties, including the regime of the same BJP from 1999 to 2004. This was not the situation.
But Dr. Ilaiah, this post-poll data for Uttar Pradesh, for Gujarat shows that a large percentage and an ever-increasing percentage of Dalits is also voting for the BJP. Far more than ever before in the past, when the RSS talks of one temple, one village, one pond, and everybody drinking from the same well, there are people who believe that they want to come together under a larger Hindu umbrella. And when constantly caste is harped about and spoken of, is that not an attempt to take India into the past instead of taking us into the future, where all castes come together?
Rahul, the notion of democracy is not entirely about vote and those who are in power with vote. If that is the case, Congress can claim about 65 years of all the vote and all the power. Therefore, they can say we should have been more dictatorial than today's governing force. The question is not that in democracy. The question is how, after coming to power, whatever vote you got, how are you handling the rights of people who don't have anything? If the tribals and the Dalits, see, why are the lowest of the low, the poorest of the poor, are scared of speaking up today? When my own book, Post-Hindu India, was, it existed from 2009 to 2017. And it was taken to the Supreme Court. The three-judge bench headed by the Chief Justice said, this book cannot be banned. And in spite of that, these people say I'm ultra-left. Now, I'll ask one question. Yes, the triple talaq issue was taken to the court by Muslim women. The BJP government intervened for equal rights of women. In the same Supreme Court, there was a case for within Hinduism, all castes who are called to be Hindu, defined to be Hindus, have a right to become priest, whether it is in Tirupati temple or Ayyappa temple or Sri Ram temple. But this government did not defend that right of Hindus who exist within that, whether they are Dalits, backwards or not. They don't believe about equality in Hinduism. Now, if you don't ask for equality in Hinduism, is it not a democratic, spiritual democratic question that if somebody is defined as Hindu, whether he's a Dalit or a backward or a Shudra or a Chandal or whatever, a Brahmin or Banya, they have the right to see the God directly on the same plane.
Okay.
This they don't defend. This they don't protect. And therefore, we are dead scared today. You call me ultra-left and you attack me. You call me any name and then you attack me. The right to speak up is ultra-left right today. I think the whole nation has to sit up and think about this. If this kind of disruptions are possible even in this kind of audience. This is not acceptable in democracy.
Okay, Vishal. You wanted to come in on the issue of whether it's only the right of the left to be offended. You know, the right say, what if we're offended as well? Whether it is with the sexy Durga, whether it is with the Padmaavat, what about the right of the right to be offended?
See, in this world of social media, you know, everyone are under the scanner, not just you, me, everyone. I think an actor can't have even a small private moment these days because everything is under the scanner. So social media is taking everything, you know, criticism, more criticism, pulling people down, especially celebrities. It's all, see, as technology advances, it's the same with, you have to accept everything else. I mean, there's nothing wrong in being offended. There's nothing wrong in expressing the opinion of the person who's offended. Just like how I've been offended. I'm not seen his film. I just asked him, you know, I clarified with him, and he said there's no poster of Goddess Durga. Yeah, it is absolutely, you know, totally out of the question where you are targeting a filmmaker with an issue which he has no idea at all. Probably he will never utilize that idea in future also to make a film.
Since so much has been said, I think Sasidharan must have the opportunity to explain why is Durga sexy.
The thing is that, you know, my friend has, said that there is a poster with Goddess Durga. Where did you see the poster? Please tell me. Where? There was no poster. There was no poster with Goddess Durga.
He is a filmmaker.
And the film is not about Goddess Durga. And Durga is a name we usually see everywhere in slums to the, you know, palaces. We can see it.
No, but you don't need to be Einstein to determine that if you name a film sexy Durga, there will be some backlash.
Let me
explain this. See, we are living in a situation, we are very much scared to express what we think because we fear a crowd, even in this closed hall, we fear that if we say something, then somebody will be offended.
No, but let me ask you this question, Shashi. No filmmaker, cineasta, makes cartoons of Prophet Muhammad. I'm giving an example out of reverence and respect to the sensibility of the Muslim community. Listen to my question before you respond. On the odd occasion when Charlie Hebdo did, you saw what happened. Even before that and after that, everyone's been very careful. So when people operate, they realize where the line of offense starts and they operate within that line. Here, is that line not being poked? Is it not a deliberate poke? Let Prakash and Sasidharan respond.
Just out of the box, sorry to interrupt. Actually, there was a film called, I think all of you must have known, and it was known to all of you, there was a South Indian film called Mersil that released last year for Diwali. Thanks to Madam Tamilisai Soundarajan and Sir H. Raja, sir, the film made a lot of crores in the box office. So I wish Sexy Durga makes a lot of crores in the box office. With this with this misinterpretation, I wish, that's the...
No,
we look at the lighter moment of it. No, honestly, we look at the lighter moment because,
as he said,
we are being choked. We are being choked. When a person...
So what stops you from making a cartoon of the prophet?
See,
that's what I'm saying. If you're not going to offend anyone,
I'm sorry to say this.
I'll just make one point.
Let me talk this. See, the question is atrocious. I must say this. Because
No, you can answer the question.
If you are asking me why you made a film named Sexy Durga, I can explain it. And you are saying that no filmmaker makes a film called Sexy Prophet, Prophet Muhammad, or Sexy Mary, or anything. And it is a super hypothetical question. How can you say that nobody is making?
Who has made? Count one for me.
See, we are
in the last several years.
See, let me finish.
No, count one.
Let me finish.
Anybody's film.
Let me finish.
You can't dodge that fact. By putting on a pretense of mock outrage, you can't deny the fact that about other religions, there is a higher level of sensitivity.
Rahul, I'll just give you a small answer. Hinduism as a religion, which is the major religion in a country of 130 crore people, should it compete with a religion which has intolerant aspects? Now, what is the intolerance aspect to the whole Buddhist world? From China to Korea to Japan to... Why don't you compete with that? Where did the whole science develop in Christian world? Jesus Christ was critiqued to the other end. Voltaire attacked Christianity to the point of death, and he was praised by the entire Christian world. What is their attitude today? That is what... The country and the Hinduism is also in danger.
Okay, let Prakash Raj respond.
That's the problem.
Nobody makes cartoons of the Prophet. Even earlier they didn't, and now they absolutely don't.
Even he has not made a film on Goddess Durga. Why are you presuming? Poor guy is saying my film is not about Durga. Nobody wants to listen to. No. You have made a film on the goddess Durga.
My question, you are seeking to shift the narrative.
Nobody will make a film on goddess Durga, on Fatima, on prophet, because it is not right.
You accept it's not right?
Yeah, he has also not made it. Poor guy.
No, but why is that not right? Why is it accepted that it is not right?
To make bad films on goddesses or somebody's beliefs, it is not right. It is not right, sir. That's why even he has not made it, poor guy.
No, but that's the question.
If he had named it Sexy Sita, you would have had a problem.
No, Prakash Raj.
Sexy Rama, then she would be the goddesses, some goddess.
I see what you're doing, but you're seeking to shift the question.
The question remains the same.
That while, of course, you can take liberties with names of Hindu goddesses.
He has not taken a liberty.
No, one second. Hear my question. You've got the name of a god there. Nobody wants to do the same with other religions. If somebody did... I'd say yes,
My film is not religious or not against any religion.
He is saying I have not done a film on the religion.
No, but that doesn't answer my question.
In which case, Rahul, Hinduism should say that nobody should adopt names of goddesses and gods in the real life. It means that. See, the
woman called Durga, who is somebody's wife, is abused every day. You have no issues about it.
See, with a name called Gautam, one can be a thief, one can be a robber, one can be anything.
No, sir.
So if there is a film on that,
sir,
does it mean that Gautam Buddha is the source of it?
In some village...
What is this?
Some village, a poor girl called Durga will be abused by her husband. They have no issues about it. Some child called Durga will not have access to education. They have no problem about it. There's some child, a 12-year-old Dalit girl, maybe named Durga, will not be given water to drink because there is no drinking facility or toilet facility in the school, and later she will have gallbladder problems. that Durga will have a health problem, malnutrition, and these people have no issues.
One of the things you said, Prakash Raj.
How can Durga names I can show in the Devadasis?
Okay, Prakash Raj, one of
Durga
the things
Durga is called Kamarupini.
Yeah, Devadasis, Durga name is there.
Durga is called Kamarupini in...
Prakash Raj, one of the things you said recently which generated headlines was that you thought that Prime Minister Modi is a better actor than you?
How many of you all agree with me? I put it on a public vote.
Very few did. Most don't agree, actually. Just a couple of hands went up. Most don't.
At least
most think you are a better actor.
I have a right. No, few accept. No.
A few accept.
I put it on vote. Let's put it on vote.
Why did you say that?
Because when he knows everything, if he's silent, in my profession, see, in Hyderabad, if there is a mechanic, and he wants to teach you a lesson, he says, Jakan dal dunga, kaam batan karti so tumna, nattam boltan titan kar dulunga. So in a vocabulary, their profession, they use metaphors from their profession. Since I am an actor, I use a metaphor from there. What is wrong in it?
You know, talk, since we've spoken so much about acting and netagiri, I want to use the minutes that we have left to talk about actors wanting to become netas. We saw Rajnikant announced very recently that he wants to set up his own political formation. We saw Kamal Hassan say he wants to set up a political formation as well. And we've got Vishal here, who filed his nomination papers, or thought he filed his nomination papers for R.K. Nagar, before two of the people who proposed his candidature said that those weren't his signatures. So who did you find? Why did you fake signatures, Vishal? What happened? How did you get rejected?
The final declaration of the person who signed said, the signature which I signed is not mine. I reiterate, the signature which I signed is not mine. So I stop it with that. So I'm so happy that India Today have called me over here with a topic saying, stand up, speak up, because I stood up and spoke up. Because I wanted it, I didn't want to dabble into politics. I didn't want to choose politics as a profession. I'm an actor. I earn more than an MLA. I have more fame than an MLA. I don't need to dwell into an alternate profession. But at that point of time, during that R.K. Nagar election, I really didn't want to sit in my house and do drawing room politics or sitting in my dining room and watch the TV and say, okay, this is how the society is going to go. No, I decided to step out. I decided to stand there. I decided to file my nomination. And then finally came this particular scenario. As you said, 10 people are supposed to, propose my signature. And till then, I didn't know that my candidature could bring about so much of fear. I mean, I would have had 100 people. I knew, there are fan clubs in R.K. Nagar. I would have had at least 100 people waiting.
You would have won?
They have decided that I'm going to win. It's forget about me whether I'm going to win or not.
You would have beaten TTV Dinakaran?
Forget TTV Dinakaran or forget Madhusudan or forget anyone. 145 candidates stood. I stood a chance. Where I stood a chance is when they rejected my nomination. Never in the history of democracy a candidate's nomination is accepted. I go back home and then I get a letter. I get it on the news saying my nomination is rejected. Fair enough. So if the fear is going to make it actually that territory and that situation made me decide on politics. Yes, I'm going to come into politics. Thanks to them. I chose to come into politics because thanks to them. If this is going to be the scenario, yes.
What is the fascination that Tamil superstars have with becoming netas?
It is the fascination towards doing good to people. See, we always think, I want to know the definition of politics. To my knowledge, politics means social service. You're reaching out to people. You're reaching out. You want to do something good on a platform. When you have power, you tend to do more good to the people. So that's the reason why there's nothing wrong. When politicians can be like actors, why not actors be politicians?
Most actors think about becoming politicians at the end of their careers. When they've had their stint at the box office, made all the hundreds of crores they wanted, bought all the land they wanted to, then they become politicians. Why is it that at the peak of your popularity when you're delivering hit after hit, you're thinking about becoming a neta.
See, it's not about where you stand in terms of your crores, or it's not about your bank balance, or about where you stand in terms of your profession. It's in terms of where the society stands. At that point of time, you take a decision to move into the society. Today, I would say that, yes, the next election in Tamil Nadu, the state election, is going to be a game changer. Yes, because I have seen, I'm not talking as a politician here. I'm talking as a representative of the people, and I've seen things happen for the few years. And I've been seeing things. And I have been seeing people wanting a change. So there's nothing wrong in Rajinikanth, making the plunge. Yes, it has been late. There's nothing wrong in Kamala Sen, sir, making the plunge. So all of them underline saying that, yes, it's not just bringing about the change to do good.
So who do you think, Vishal, will be the most successful neta? Superstar Rajinikanth, the cerebral Kamal Hassan, or the reigning hero, Vishal?
I still have to see the agenda of Rajini sir and Kamal Hassan sir. It's the announcement that has been made. The agenda is yet to come, and we as voters are looking forward to what.
Voters or competitors?
See, as I said,
no, Rahul,
the
I
next state assembly,
one point.
The next state assembly election will be a game changer. I told you,
no,
they
so
have decided
again, in the next state election, and this is a tantalizing possibility. Will we have one party of Rajinikanth, one party of Kamal Hassan, one party of Vishal, apart from the DMK, the AIDMK?
For
the
all
DMK,
you know, I know Prakash Raj sir is going to stand in the election.
Which state, Prakash Raj? Which state? You'll also fight in
no,
Tamil Nadu?
No, we want him in Tamil Nadu first.
Huh? He said, I'm Kannada. Where will you fight? You'll fight the fourth.
We want him in Tamil Nadu first. I want him in Tamil Nadu
first. See, this is what happens with his films also, and that's what he was telling me earlier. It's fantastic that the people of Tamil Nadu think he's theirs, the people of Karnataka think he's theirs. So where will you fight? Karnataka Assembly or Tamil Nadu Assembly?
Definitely in India.
No, otherwise you could do what Arvind Kejriwal did next time. Fight against the man who you think is a better actor than you.
No, I'm a very good actor. I've got 5 national awards.
You never thought of returning any of these awards?
No. Certain films may be a hit. I'm a consistently a good actor.
Okay,
I know the nuances well. And I want to tell them in the language of cinema, the script of trying to put down dissent, a script to force a narrative. I want to tell those gentlemen, it is like a script which they wanted to make around 60, 70 years back. They didn't get a chance. They have got it now, and it's a bad script. It's an outdated script. Okay, the results are showing, and there is a silent majority who want to correct their mistake, and I'm sure.
But the larger, more vocal majority seem to like this script. They think it's a political box office success.
So some bad films also run. We don't know why. But you can't repeat them.
No, actually from...
you don't know what snowballs in this country.
Whether it's Gujarat or before that, whether it is Uttar Pradesh, Maharashtra, Haryana, they seem to be delivering political box office success month after month, election after election.
That's okay. Five states. For you, it is a success. For me, it is...
No, she's actually saying there were 5 rapes in Haryana. That's what she's talking.
See, that's also their success. That's also their success. It's okay. See, I am a very interesting... I make a film called Kanjivaram, for which I got the National Award for the Best Actor. It didn't run a day in theater. I never got paid for this film also. But I did a commercial film with 5 fights and 6 rapes and things and all. It ran for 100 days. But that doesn't mean I have to accept it, right? Isn't it?
So
just because, no. See, this majoritism, this sarvadhikar, at now it may look at like that, but then you please see, let them be consistent. Let's see.
Okay, so tell
now, I'll just make one.
We make mistakes, it's okay.
I'm looking at it as a political scientist. See, the real success, succeeding actors were in the regional languages and states. MGR first and NTR later. Jayalalitha's entry is through MGR later. Now, subsequently, actors came and failed. Chiranjeevi is a classical example. Now, in my view, in the Bollywood, they tried in the North Indian domain, but they failed. including the big boss in film. Even in Tamil Nadu now, I think those days of political film actors really succeeding in elections is not possible.
So you are not giving Vishal a chance? Give him a chance. Let him
Vishal
try.
Has a lot of time to go. His signature has to be accepted first. His signature has to be accepted first. So he has not learned to how to sign now. It means that.
Prakash Raj, out of Kamal Hassan, Rajnikanth, Vishal, who do you think has the best chance?
All of them have equally good chance. And I think all three of them claiming that or trying to deciding that we will be the leaders will not be enough. People will decide who is the leader. Because Tamil Nadu, as far as Tamil Nadu politics is concerned, I know desperately, frantically, people need a change. It's left to them that the agendas they give, will it go with the need of those people? And probably to some extent, their personal popularities, which has been there, may help. But if all three of them win just because they are popular in Tamil Nadu, nobody can save Tamil
Kancha
Nadu.
Kancha Ilaiah says Let society finish. Has evolved.
Let me finish. Yeah. If these three of them win the elections just because they are popular, nobody can save Tamil Nadu. Tamil Nadu, I am with the people to tell them, vote for the change. And I'm sure, having moved with all three of them, I know their compassion, I know their intentions, I know how serious they are. And I hope, I believe, I pray, all three of you come together because your agenda is the same.
Kancha Ilaiah says, society has moved on from the times of NTR, from the times of MGR, where actors would be accepted as netas only yes, because of their popularity. You agree?
I do agree,
see,
it has changed.
Look at MGR's life. He was not just actor when he was in the peak of his life in cinema. He was an activist in DK movement also for a long time. Neither Kamal Hassan nor any other are equivalent to that. NTR is a different exceptional case because he was not only a very popular actor in the mythological domain as well, but there was a Telugu sentiment at that time, vis-a-vis Delhi, what happened during Rajiv Gandhi's situation. I don't think today Tamil Nadu is facing similar situation. And if Rajinikanth moves towards the right, as the signals are coming out, I think if he contests, he'll be wiped out even against Shashikala also. Because Shashikala's...
So now you are saying things that Mr. Rao is just charging from his seat then.
No, but...
Let us not say, why are we saying Rajni sir is going that?
Yeah.
Let us not get into speculation.
Do you think that because we know that RSS ideologue Mr. Gurumurthy and Rajni sir have been in touch and that Gurumurthy is generally seen as the political ideologue or the brain think tank behind Rajnikant's political foray. Do you think it will be a big mistake keeping Tamil pride in mind if Rajnikanth were to in some way be seen as allying with the right?
See, it's all up to him to decide. As I said, one human has come out from his comfort zone and he said that he's going to, contest in the future elections. It's like, it's the first step. There's still more to come from him. Waiting for him to speak more, waiting for us to hear more, waiting for us to connect. So there's a lot more time.
So one of the similarities between what MGR did and you is that both had complete control of the Film Producers Association. So you control the cine industry in the state. Is that something that you did consciously as a stepping stone to your political innings?
Yeah, start activism.
Vice president and I'm the president of the producer council of Tamil Nadu. See, the fact when we youngsters decided to step in and, we had a reason for that. There was a building to be built and we asked a question and we were shunted out. So we decided, okay, there is no other choice but to contest an election. We contested and we won phenomenally well. We all came in and whatever we promised, we have delivered. The same happened with the producer council because everyone knows that the film industry is reeling under piracy. I sincerely take this opportunity. Still I'm waiting for the central government to take up a stringent step to curb piracy, which will be a boon to the film industry, not just Tamil film industry, the entire Indian film industry. The same, you know, perspective at how they look at adult porn sites. I wish they, you know, look at the illegal websites that download, you know, you have free downloads of films. So that's the reason why we decided to again clean up the system over there in the prevailing system. And we won. And yes, again, we are delivering whatever we conveyed. Nowhere in this picture was, you know, the history, as you said, that MGR, you know, contested, Vijay Kansa contested, and then they plunged into politics. Sometimes there's always a coincidence. I always see this as a coincidence.
Prakash, does it make more sense for all actors to contest together as one umbrella against the...
See, now we'll stop it. See, the point is actors or any artist for that matter, I think what is important today is they should have a political conscience. They come from a society, they derive from a society. And when there are voiceless people, I think an artist who is a more sensitive person needs to react, needs to stand, as simple as that. And let's not make it into just actors coming in, writers come in, doctors come in, whoever comes in, that's fine. And at the same time, we also have seen a lot of actors have become MPs and MLAs, and they have been the useless lot of this country. Aren't they? So don't think all actors are right. That's why I'm asking people with my just asking tag, ask questions, choose, think before you choose. Don't vote for anyone just because you're their fan. You know, that doesn't help this country.
Everyone who's sitting here at the India Today South Conclave should really, for a moment, acknowledge the fact that we often criticize actors, filmmakers in Bollywood for not having the courage to speak up. What we've seen today is an exposition of how we've got people with different political orientation having the courage to stand up and speak up and to be counted. And I think that by itself is spectacular. Whether you or anybody else watching on TV agree or disagree with what they're saying, I think the most important thing is that they have the courage of their convictions to say what they have. And others must sit and watch. If you're offended, listen to Mr. Rao and everybody else, or turn the TV off. But what you can't and should not do is to charge at the actor or the filmmaker and try to cut his nose off or poke his eye. That's not okay. Because the right to free speech is integral to who we are, and that right cannot be silenced. So will you continue to bash on regardless, Vishal, in this fashion, or does the extreme reaction sometime make you think it's better to stay shut?
See, my sincere request again is to filmmakers also. We need to bridge the gap. As I said, we are bashing the Central Board of Film Certification, saying that they have the right to only certify a film so that you have like 15 plus or 12 plus or 18 plus. Yes, but you can't cut portions of the film. It's filmmakers seek attention. Filmmakers make films to seek attention of people. But the Censor Board of Film Certification, they actually think that audience seek retention. Nobody is going to take the content back home and again, you know, being influenced by it. And it's not going to make such a huge impact.
So you're saying filmmakers seek attention. Is that also why?
Yes, there's nothing wrong. We are here to make films. Over the year, we are here to make films.
Actually, see, without seeing the film, you can't judge a film. You need to see a film before you making allegation. That is the only request I have to make. And there is a consciousness is building that, you know, beating up a filmmaker or, blocking a film also is a part of expression, freedom of expression. My friend was saying that, you know, we have also freedom of expression. Okay, you can protest. You can make statement, or you can make a counter film, or whatever. But you can't go and trash Sanjay Leela Bhansali. And whenever a film got even a court order, I got a court order stating that the central government should screen the film in IFFI, and that court order was actually denied by blocking the censor certificate. So you can't do that. That is the only problem. Otherwise, it is okay. You can protest, you can make statement, you can counterclaim, or you can counter make films, everything.
But this
so
is
that's
not
an
right.
idea for Mr. Rao there. You can make a film of the kind that you want. Yes, Prakash Raj. You continue to bash on, regardless, do you think that sometimes the voice of dissent is silenced or threatened by extreme reactions?
Why will I stop this beautiful life where I have found meaning to live? I'll continue to ask.
Well, Rahul, as a social activist, stood by the Dalit tribals backwards for 45 years. I believe that whether it is in this regime or any other regime, when the poor, when the illiterate, when the ignorant in huge numbers are suffering, the only way to defend them and see that they also reach the goal that I reached or the stage that I reached from a shepherd family is to stand out and speak up. Consistently, whether we die or live, that is not the issue for the nation, but standing out and speaking up is the constitutional right that I got from Ambedkar's pen. I will not give up till my last blood.
I let that be the last word on this session, but you must have the right to stand up and speak up without having to worry about whether you live or die because you did. Thank you so much for joining us here at the India Today Conclave South, and thank you for lighting up this session with the kind of things that you said. We leave it to everyone who's watching here and elsewhere to decide what they make of it. Thank you.